Good morning, everyone. I welcome you all to the 20th annual convocation of the International Institute of Information Technology, Bangalore. We shall brief you about our growth as a renowned institution. The International Institute of Information Technology, Bangalore was established in 1999 jointly by the government of Karnataka and the IT industry with the mission to build on the track record set by India in general and Bangalore in particular to enable India to play a key role in the global IT scenario through a world-class institute with a focus on education and research, entrepreneurship and innovation. In 2005, the institute was recognized under Section 3 of the University Grants Commission Act as a deemed to be university in the de novo category. IIIT Bangalore has established itself as an IT-focused postgraduate educational and research institute, awarding MTech, Integrated MTech, MSc in Digital Society, Master of Science by Research, and PhD degrees. Evaluation by the National Accreditation and Assessment Council in March 2014 awarded IIIT Bangalore an A, the highest grade, under the latest ranking released by NIRF in 2020, IIIT Bangalore is ranked at 62. Our alumni have grown from strength to strength, and we are proud to say that in our 20-year growth, we thus far have an alumni strength of 3,007, excluding today's graduates. I now call upon our students, Lasya, Jhelum and Shivani for the invocation. Raksha will accompany on the veena. Thank you, students. I request Professor Nandita Rao to deliver the welcome speech.
Ellarigu namaskara. A very good morning to all of you. As always, we start with a famous Kannada saying. Yedavadaye mai gaya vadayadaye maguvaru nadaya kalitavanu mati neeti gatiyantu tadavarisi muggarisi biddu matteddu mai dadavikolluvavarella Mankutimma. This means no child has ever learned to walk without falling down. This is how the mind learns wisdom. To slip, to fall, and to shake oneself and get up, this is what everyone does. This is one of the famous sayings from Mankutimmana Kagga, written by Dr. D.V. Gundappa, and is widely regarded as a masterpiece of Kannada literature. This saying is very relevant to our current situation. This has been a season of terrible losses all over the world. People have lost their lives and families are grieving. Some have lost their jobs, their savings, the plans for their future. With such large-scale devastation, it might seem very trivial to feel sad about losing your graduation ceremonies. But many of you may not agree with me. A college graduation is a big deal. It is important. And for the last couple of decades, we have celebrated it with the procession, conferring of degrees, the graduation gown, and most importantly, photos to celebrate what you accomplished. But for the class of 2020, all of this will happen virtually, and we hope you will enjoy it, and a lot of effort has gone behind making this convocation happen. In spite of the tough times, you, the students who have become graduates today, have gained something very important. As young people, you have been tested and you did not fail. You kept going. And therefore, we celebrate you today, the graduating batch of 2020. On that note, it's my great pleasure to welcome everyone, our esteemed guests, and all of you to this online graduation, the 20th convocation of IIIT Bangalore. On behalf of the chairman, members of the governing body, the director, faculty, staff, and students, I welcome our chief guest, Professor Jitendra Malik, and our guest of honor, Mr. Krishna Kumar Natarajan. Professor Jitendra Malik received his BTech in Electrical Engineering from IIT Kanpur in 1980 and PhD in Computer Science from Stanford University in 1985. He then joined the University of California at Berkeley, where he is currently the Arthur J. Chick Professor in the Department of Electrical Engineering and Computer Science. He is also on the faculty of the Department of Bioengineering and the Cognitive Science and Vision Science groups. Since January 2018, he is also the research director and site lead of Facebook AI research in Menlo Park. Professor Malik's research group has worked on different topics in computer vision, computational modeling of human vision, computer graphics, and the analysis of biological images. He has mentored more than 60 PhD students and postdoctoral fellows. He received the gold medal for the best graduating student in electrical engineering from IIT Kanpur in 1980, and a Presidential Young Investigator Award in 1989. At UC Berkeley, he was selected for the Diane S. McIntyre Award for Excellence in Teaching in 2000 and a Miller Research Professorship in 2001. He received the Distinguished Alumnus Award from IIT Kanpur in 2008. His publications have received numerous Best Paper Awards. It's a great pleasure to welcome you, sir. Our guest of honor, Mr. Krishna Kumar Natarajan, is the co-founder of Mindtree and managing partner of Mela Ventures. A leading authority in the global IT sector, Mr. Krishna Kumar Natarajan co-founded Mindtree in 1999 and has played key roles in building the company's innovative approach to delivering IT services and solutions. In his prior role as CEO and managing director from April 2008 to March 2016, Mr. Krishna Kumar was responsible for making Mindtree a global IT player. His efforts as a business leader has been recognized worldwide, winning him several laurels. Business World and Forbes ranked him amongst the most valuable CEOs in India in 2016. He won Business Today CEO of the Year Award in 2014 and was recognized by Chief Executive Magazine as one of the 12 global leaders of tomorrow. His efforts resulted in Mindtree winning the award of Most Promising Company of the Year in 2013 by CNBC TV18. A 39-year IT industry veteran, Mr. Krishna Kumar held several key positions at Wipro before co-founding Mindtree. He now serves as the chairman of NASSCOM Foundation. With great pleasure, we welcome you, sir. I now welcome Mr. S. Gopal Krishnan, the chairman of the governing body of IIIT Bangalore, who has stood behind all our endeavors and has been a key guiding force in IIIT's growth. I also welcome the members of the governing body, the general body of IIIT Bangalore. I would like to extend a warm welcome to our director, Professor S. Sadagopan, who has steered us through 20 convocations, which essentially demonstrates his vision and efforts that has resulted in the graduation of over 3,000 students from IIIT Bangalore. I welcome all our faculty members and staff, distinguished academicians from other institutes, CEOs and executives of IT companies, officials of the government of Karnataka, the press, and all the invitees. Finally, this event is for the graduating students, the class of 2020. We are happy to send you to the world as trained and motivated citizens who can stay tough. So a warm welcome to the graduating students and to the proud families of these students. Thank you.
Thank you, Professor. I request our chairman, Mr. S. Gopalakrishnan, to declare the convocation open.
I declare the 20th convocation of the International Institute of Information Technology, Bangalore, open.
Thank you, sir. I request our director, Professor S. Sadagopan, to present the annual report of the institute.
Good morning. Chief guest of the day, Professor Jitendra Malik. Guest of honor of the day, Mr. Krishna Kumar. Chairman of the governing body, Mr. Gopalakrishnan. Other members of the governing body, members of the Senate, my distinguished faculty colleagues, my dear students, more importantly, the graduating students, alumni and staff, interestingly distributed across continents. Welcome to the 20th convocation of IIITB. It's a moment of joy when 282 of our students, 7 with a PhD degree, 13 with Master of Science by Research degree, 159 with a 2-year M.Tech degree, 11 with MSc degree, 63 students with dual degrees, and 29 students with sponsored 2-year M.Tech degree graduate. Convocation is a celebration of success, a celebration of success of the graduating students. Please join me in congratulating our class of 2020 students and their families who have supported the students. The year 2019-2020 is very special for this planet. COVID-19 introduced so many challenges. Every organization had to innovate its own way of facing this challenge. IIITB did this by way of moving 100% to online teaching of classes for the last 6 weeks of classes and moving to e-convocation today. We would have loved to host all the graduating students and their parents in person today, but e-convocation appeared to be the best under the current trying circumstances. There is no visibility till the year end when it will be safe to have a large congregation on the campus. Provisional degrees may harm a small number of students who may be denied a job or admission by an excessively rule-minded person. We did not want our students to suffer. Today's e-convocation posed its own challenges. Mr. Murphy at work. Saturday, 27th June, the government of Karnataka declared a curfew on all Sundays, and it starts today. Since all degree certificates have been printed, signed, and framed, in fact, with several security features, rescheduling was not an option. As we speak, we are delivering this experience completely on cloud and hoping to deliver this 100% e-convocation proceedings flawlessly and pray that our efforts do not go waste. Again, we would have loved to have Professor Jitendra Malik, chief guest of the day, in person with us today. It is very kind of him to agree to join us in the form of e-presence. I do not want to stand in the way of our students getting their degrees, yet it is customary to present very select highlights of the institute on this occasion. Please permit me to do so. I will be very brief. First, on students' front, please join me in congratulating our MSc student Nivin Mathew for winning the first prize on National Blind Tennis Championship. Until he won this award, many of us did not even know of such a game. Blind tennis, where the ball is smart. He has been selected for the international event, scheduled to take place in Italy. Our PhD student, Oindrila Mathilal, won the Best Paper Award at European Conference on Computer-Supported Work. Please join me in congratulating our PhD student, Rajavel Swami, for his election to 3GPP. The highest standards body in the world for LTE and 5G as vice chairman. Interestingly, he is our M.Tech alum and works for Samsung. On alumni front, please join me in congratulating Kadim Bachi, an alum from the very first batch of M.Tech students. His startup WhatFix received Series C funding of $32 million recently. On faculty front, please join me in congratulating Professor R. Chandrasekhar for being adjudged the top 10 data science academician for a second time in a row by Analytics India magazine. Professors Sridhar and Srisha Rao won Facebook Award for Ethics in AI, one of the 6 teams from India. Please join me in congratulating Professor Manish Gupta, who was selected by Google to head the Google Research Lab India in September 2019. Institutionally, we are getting more and more international, perhaps doing justice to our name. Modular Open Source Identity Program, MOSIP, is a project that IIITB is hosting, and it is getting lots of traction. Morocco was the first country to adopt MOSIP in 2018. Indonesia and Ethiopia signed MOU in 2019. Sri Lanka is likely to sign up in 2020. Special must be made of the fact that the chairman of Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation, Mr. Bill Gates, decided to personally review this project funded by BGMF and spent nearly an hour with the project team from IIITB led by Professor Rajagopalan in Seattle in October. IIITB joined the prestigious Web Science Trust Labs Network, a network of select 20 global institutes including MIT, Imperial College, NUS, KAIST, and Tsinghua. The institute continues to mentor MIIT, Myanmar Institute of Information Technology, with a full contingent of IIITB selected faculty members from India. The very first batch of the undergraduate students, after completing their 5 years of BE honors, are expected to graduate in October 2020. IIITB won the Best Exhibitor Award in BTS 2019, the largest tech event in India, in November, the first time we ever put up an institute stall, ever. All through the 20 years, we have been successful in placing all but a handful of students on the day of the convocation. This is significant as our academic year gets over by 30th of June and all our convocations happen on the very first or the second Sunday of July. And this is all the more significant this year because of COVID-19. I'm happy to share that this year is no different for IIITB. We'll continue to work hard to place the remaining students also. We are grateful to our friends from the industry for their continued support on this front. Finally, institution building is an act of faith, but for the trust-based relationship between the governing body and the executive, IIITB would not be what it is today. We look forward to such continued support from the management and from all sections, namely faculty, students, staff, alumni, funding agencies, government, industry, and civil society. We have a long way to go, but our baby steps in the past 20 years are reassuring. Congratulations to the graduating batch again, and welcome one and all.
Thank you, sir. I request our director, Professor S. Sadagopan, to kindly seek permission from the chairman, Mr. S. Gopalakrishnan, to present the students of the graduating class.
Sir, I have the honor of requesting you to permit us to present the qualified students of the PhD, Master of Science by Research, M.Tech, M.Sc., and Integrated M.Tech programs for the award of degrees.
This convocation has been called to confer the relevant degrees upon the candidates who have been certified to be worthy of the same. Let the candidates stand forward and take the oath.
Thank you, sirs. I request our registrar to administer the oath to the students of the graduating class that shall guide them throughout their lives. The students of the graduating class are requested to rise and take the oath.
I promise to work
for a better world.
For a better world.
Where science and technology
Are used in socially responsible ways.
I will not use my education
for
any purpose,
for any purpose,
intended to harm human beings,
intended to harm human beings,
or the environment,
or the environment.
Throughout my career, I will consider the ethical implications.
I will consider the ethical implications
of my work, before I take action. Even when the demands placed upon me
may be great,
I promise to do
my alma mater
proud.
By abiding
by this declaration, wherever I am,
I recognize that
Individual responsibility
is the first step
on the path to global well-being. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, students. I request our director, Professor S. Sadagopan, to request our chairman, Mr. S. Gopalakrishnan, to accept the students who are qualified for the relevant degrees.
Sir, as director, I have the honor of presenting to you the candidates of PhD, Master of Science by Research, Master of Technology, MSc, and Integrated MTech programs for the award of degrees, whose names are set out in the list. They have been found qualified for the said degree, to which I pray they may be admitted.
By virtue of the authority vested in me as the chairman of the governing body, and upon the recommendations of the Senate of International Institute of Information Technology, Bangalore, I admit all the qualified candidates to the relevant degree. I have the pleasure of commencing the virtual distribution of the degrees to all the graduating students.
Thank you, sir. On behalf of our chairman, Mr. S. Gopalakrishnan, we will commence announcement of the award of Doctor of Philosophy degrees. I request the supervisors of the graduating research students to introduce their respective PhD students.
The degree of Doctor of Philosophy is awarded to Mrs. Gracie Phillip for her thesis titled Architecture Model-Based Safety Assurance and Validation Framework.
The degree of Doctor of Philosophy is awarded to Mr. Ramakrishnan Raman for his thesis titled Decision Learning Framework for Architecture Design Decisions for Complex Systems and System of Systems.
The degree of Doctor of Philosophy is awarded to Balachandra K. for his thesis titled Some Novel Contributions to Understanding Indian Classical Music Using Computational Techniques. Professor Punacha is a co-supervisor.
The degree of Doctor of Philosophy is awarded to Soumya Rasipuram for her thesis titled Computational Analysis of Communication Skill in Job Interview Scenarios.
The degree of Doctor of Philosophy is awarded to Neha Orang for her thesis titled Design of Nanomagnetic Logic from Gates to Subsystem.
The degree of Doctor of Philosophy is awarded to Ms. Gopika Gopin K. for her thesis titled EEG Time Series, Classification and Analysis. The thesis course supervisor is Professor Dinesh Babu Jagopi.
The degree of Doctor of Philosophy is awarded to K. E. Manjunath for his thesis titled Study of Multilingual Phone Recognition Using Indian Languages. Professor Dinesh Babu Jagopi is the co-supervisor.
Thank you, professors. On behalf of our chairman, Mr. S. Gopalakrishnan, we will commence announcement of the award of Master of Science by Research degrees. I request the supervisors of the graduating research students to introduce their respective students.
I invite Anant Kumar Das to accept the degree of Master of Science by Research for his work on detecting architectural tactic and code smells in source code.
The degree of Master of Science by Research is awarded to Mr. Nitin Bhatia for his thesis titled Formal Verification of Software for Programmable Graphics Processing Unit.
The degree of Master of Science by Research is awarded to Pooja Rao for her thesis titled Improving Asynchronous Interview System with Automatic Assessment and Follow-up Question Generation.
The degree of Master of Science by Research is awarded to Mr. Sharad Srivatsa for his thesis entitled Narrative Plot Comparison Using a Bag of Actors Document Model.
The degree of Master of Science by Research is awarded to Pradeep Kumar Iri for his thesis titled Entropy-Based Thresholding for Image Segmentation and Classification of Intra-Class Images. The degree of Master of Science by Research is awarded to Vaishnav Ram Savarni for his thesis titled Image Denoising with Feedback Control-Based Window Size Selection and Ripple-Based Edge-Aware Smoothing.
The degree of Master of Science by Research is awarded to Kiran G. for his thesis titled Investigation into the Development of Conditioner Integrated Capacitive Sensor for Measurement of Rotor Blade Tip Clearance. The co-supervisor was Professor Subir Roy. The degree of Master of Science by Research is awarded to K.N. Ahish for his thesis titled Ultrasound-Based Real-Time Guided Surgery for Treating Hydrocephalus, Prototype Implementation and Evaluation.
The degree of Master of Science by Research is awarded to Spurti M.N. for her thesis titled Hardware Design for Decimal Multiplication, a Semi-Parallel Iterative Approach.
The degree of Master of Science by Research is awarded to Tripti Agarwal for her thesis titled Topological Similarity Measures Between Multi-Field Data.
The degree of Master of Science by Research is awarded to Shomo Dash for his work on automation and organizational work practices, enactment of ICTs in public sector retail banks in India.
The degree of Master of Science by Research is awarded to Sarvari Ravindran for her thesis titled Efficient Network Slicing MAC Protocol for System Resource Optimization in 5G Radio Access Network. Her work co-supervised by Professor Josna Bapat. The degree of Master of Science by Research is awarded to Tushar Vrindh for his thesis titled Efficient MAC Layer Algorithms for Resource Allocation in Aerial Communication of 6G Wireless Networks.
Thank you, professors. On behalf of our chairman, Mr. S. Gopalakrishnan, we will now commence distribution of Master of Technology degrees. I request the registrar to announce the names of the students graduating with degree in M.Tech in CSE.
Rajat Agarwal, Ayush Farkya, Nanda Abhay Naresh Bhai, Aditya Avasti, Ajay Veer, Akruti Chavre, Akshada Kamle, Akshat Agarwal, Aman Gupta, Amir Malik, Amisha Jain, Anirudh Pratap Singh, Ankit Gupta, Ankit Pathania, Ankit Ramtriya, Ankit Singh, Ansh Goel, Shah Anuj Rajesh, Sangvi Archit Kinjal Bhai, Ayush Singh, Ayush Yadav, Bharatiya Pawan Vijay Kumar, Gulecha Bhavesh Praveen Chand, Sahitya Bhavisha Kishan, Vishwaroop Banerjee, Chaitanya Sharma, Chandramouli Gupta, Damini, Devender Singh, D.S. Deepak, Deepta Das Chaudhary, Divya Garg, Divyanshi Singhal, Gaurav Shyam Sundar Joshi, Gaurav Kumar Singh, Gaurav Junjunwala, Jaju Govinda Dilip Kumar, Harsh Tripathi, Vyas Hima Atul Bhai, Jagdeep Patnaik, Jagmeet Singh, Kakkad Jay Kumar Manoj Bhai, Godani Jaydeep Ramesh Bhai, Jalak Anant Nayak, Jyoti Kondal, Karambir Singh, Karuna Nidhan Upadhyay, Kasi Bhotla Sai Kishore, Keshav Agarwal, Kishore Kunal, Kritika Jain, Lokesh Garg, Mangesh Wagle, Manish Kumar, Manisha Sharma, Manisha Sinha, Manpreet Singh Tuteja, Mayank Nigam, Mayur Rajwani, Mohammad Rashid Niaz, Meenal Agarwal, Mohammad Irfan Sultan, Mohammad Arbhab Khan, Mudit Mittal, Naman Bhatt, Naman Raj Varshne, Navdeep Singh, Nilesh Kumar, Nimesh Krishnani, Niral Jain, Nitesh Rautela, Nitin Agarwal, Nitin Gupta, Pankaj, Parul Parikh, Mentala Prabhanjan Reddy, Praful Gupta, Pragya Gupta, Pranjal Dube, Pranjal Gupta, Sangatni Prashant Ashok, Pritanjali Ray, Prerna Arora, Princy Goel, Gogale Pratish Rajesh, Priyanka Agarwal, Kulkarni Pushkar Sunil Rao, Rahul Kumar Rai, Rahul Ranjan, Rajiv Pankaj Shukla, Rakesh Kumar, Ravindra Singh Pawar, Rishabh Singh, Rupak Rastogi, Junjunwala Sagar Sanjay, Getia Sagar Rajesh, Sahil Paul, Kotla Sai Charan Reddy, Samriddhi Kundalia, Sandeep Kar, Satyam Khare, Saurabh Mehta, Saurabh Pahawa, Sayantan Mujumdar, Shardul Lingwal, Shiva Gupta, Shravak Chaudhary, Shreyans Jain, Darwokar Shubham Deepak,
Shubham Jindal, Shubham Kashyap, Shubham Bosana, Shah Siddhant Sanjay Kumar, Sonveer Tomar, Kondapaka Veerabhadra Saurabh, G. Srinivasa Rao, Sumit Chakraborty, Lele Suparna Satyaprakash, Suryans Jain, Tigala Sarika, Tirumala Reddy, Janardana Reddy, Tushar B. Bharadwaj, Narang Tushar Rajesh, Karsh Agarwal, Vaishali Walia, Vasu Bansal, Vikas Sharma, Vipasa Bose, Vivek Gupta, Yamini Sharma, Motwani Yogesh, Purushottam Kumar.
Thank you, sir. I now request the registrar to read the names of students graduating with degree in M.Tech in ECE.
Adarsh Das, Aishwarya Kumar Sharma, Gumbuluri Ajay, Anjali Joshi, Anmol Jain, Ayushi Shukla, Dainik Gupta, Karthik D, Karthik S, Kohli Sai Saturam Reddy, Mayank Chaturvedi, Mayuk Ghosh, Modapalli Ram Mohan, Priyanka Vadhani, Purbasha Panda, Rachit Parsai, Palakurti Rawali, Sarvesh S. Nandkar, Segu Ila, Shivankit Bharadwaj, Shubham Babel, Padinini Siva Monika, Nomula Shravanti, Swagatika Mohapatra, Swetashri Mishra, Manchikanti Venkata Sai Krishna, Vikas Agarwal.
Thank you, sir. On behalf of our guest of honor, Mr. N. Krishna Kumar, we will now commence announcing the names of students under sponsored M.Tech program and Master of Science in Digital Society program. I request the registrar to announce the names of students from the sponsored M.Tech program graduating with a degree in M.Tech in Computer Science and Engineering.
Lalit Kumar, Udit Bhargava, Ankit Yadu, Dinakar Reddy Y, Gaurav Kumar Gupta, Gunjan Kumar Chaudhary, Inbarajan P, Kumud Kumar Sinha, Manjit Hotha, Narendra Putiala, Nishchal Jain, Edda R. Moses Manoj Kumar, Rahul Kumar, Ronak Biswas, Ravish Kumar Kumawat, Saikat Kumar Das, Satya Chandrane at Santosh S, C. Satya Ganesh Nutan Dev, Shankar Kumar Pankaj, Sharmila M, Sashi Kumar Parwani, Saubarnika T, Srinivasa Rao E, Sudarshan Rao B, Suhas PK, Surendra Pandey, Talakala Grace Hanusha, Veerabhadrappa M. Gadak, Vikash Mishra.
Thank you, sir. I request the registrar to read the names of students graduating with degree in MSc in Digital Society.
M. Badri Narayan, Amel Darshan Mohan, Girish K, Janani AP, Siddhartha Quatra, Shravya C, Vivek Poddar, Andika Hendrasika, Faik Vildana, Fajar Rulhudana, Hario Bismo Kuntarto.
Thank you, sir. On behalf of our guest of honor, Mr. N. Krishnakumar, we will now commence distribution of Master of Technology and Bachelor of Technology degrees for the students belonging to the Integrated Master of Technology program. I request the registrar to announce the names of students from the Integrated M.Tech program graduating with Master of Technology in CSE and Bachelor of Technology in CSE degrees.
Kosanam Manoshri, Monica Nirukonda, Aditya Ramesh, Abhiraman R, Aditya Ankush, Akshay Pant, Alavala Deepika, Anaga Vishnu Vajjala, Anshuman Das, Ankit Ghalawat, Atharva Anant Deshpande, Balanagu Sri Raman, Cherukumbili Ram Kashyap, G. Shravya, Ghantasala Urmila, Himang Kansal, Ayyar Shreyas Srinivasan, Jui Singh, Kashish Jain, Kedar Milan Kulkarni, Kushagraya Khare, Madhu Venkata Srinivasa Charan, Mahit Bhima, Makkala Praneet Reddy, Mamilla Kartikeya Reddy, Mohammad Shahbaz, Naman Dosi, Nihal Kuglugi, Pipaliya Shiloni Manish, Potluri Sai Rakshit, Rachit Jain, Raghavarappu Venkateshwara Rao, Ramisetti Lakshmi Priya, Shivang Arora, Suggu Sai Sankit, Suraj Singh, Surya Srikar Peruri, Udit Jindal, Utkarsh Agarwal, Vaibhav Agarwal, Vegi Mohit, Venkata K.C. Ritvik Goparaju, Y. Harshavardhan, Rohil Pal.
Thank you, sir. I now request the registrar to announce the names of the students from the Integrated M.Tech program graduating with Master of Technology in Electronics and Communication Engineering and Bachelor of Technology in Information Technology in Electronics and Communication Engineering degrees.
Gogineni Dharmik, Anshika Gupta, Anshuk Uppal, Aparna D. Nair, Cherikuri Sai Vivek, Dasari Soumya, Gauri Setti Vishnu Sai Sankeet, Ketari Sai Praneet Reddy, Krishna Nagaraja, P. Vamsi Krishna, Pranav Agarwal, टी आदित्य, उत्कर्ष प्रताप सिंह, विनय चंद्रशेखर के, वोगु अरविंद रेड्डी, वाईवीएस ज्ञानेश्वर रेड्डी, एलन इज़वेल एम, भारत एन, प्राची प्रवीण दामागने।
थैंक यू सर। ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ आवर चीफ गेस्ट प्रोफेसर जितेंद्र मले, वी विल नाउ कमेंस अनाउंसमेंट ऑफ अवार्ड्स एंड मेडल्स। आई रिक्वेस्ट फैकल्टी इन चार्ज फॉर फेलोशिप्स एंड अवार्ड्स प्रोफेसर अमित चट्टोपाध्याय टू अनाउंस द विनर्स।
इट इज माय ग्रेट प्लेजर to announce the awardees of sponsored medals and awards of 2020. Sir M. Visvesvaraya Scholarship Awards are given to the top male and female students with highest CGPA among all the courses. This year, Sir M. Visvesvaraya Scholarship Award male goes to Karthik S. And Sir M. Visvesvaraya Scholarship Award female goes to Shravya C. Let Sri N. Ramarao medals are awarded in three categories. Student of the Year Award is based on academic performance and other academic achievements. This year, let Sri N. Ramarao medal for Student of the Year Award goes to Vinay Chandrasekhar K. All-Rounder of the Year Award recognizes exceptional all-round activities, academic, community, and organizational. This year, let Sri N. Ramarao Medal for All-Rounder of the Year Award is being awarded to MBS Charan. Entrepreneur of the Year Award recognizes entrepreneurial achievements of our alumni. This year, the award goes to Jayastika Khasnavish. Jayastika Khasnavish is a 2014 graduate and is an entrepreneur and technology leader with more than 9 years of experience. He has worked with multiple product MNCs and startups before starting Krishi Hub. At Krishi Hub, Jayastika and his team are building technology-driven agricultural ecosystem for Indian farmers. He has won multiple awards and accolades for Krishi Hub's contribution to Indian agri-tech sector, including Forbes 30, Under 30 Asia, NASSCOM Emerge 50, and Facebook Code for Next Billion. Sitaram Jindal Gold Medal, sponsored by Sitaram Jindal Foundation, is awarded to highest CGPA holder in the IMTech program. This year, Sitaram Jindal Gold Medal goes to Vinay Chandrasekhar K. It is my pleasure to announce awardees of the Institute Medals and Awards of 2020. Institute Medal for Contribution to IIITB Community Life recognizes students for their contribution to community activities at IIITB. This year, the medal is awarded to Vikas Sharma. Institute Medal for Contribution to IIITB Professional Life recognizes students for their contribution to professional activities at IIITB. This year, the medal is awarded to Gaurav Joshi. Finally, the Institute Gold Medals. These are awarded to the best graduating students as determined by the CGPA in the respective courses. This year, the Institute Gold Medal for MTech goes to Saubarnika T. The Institute Gold Medal for IMTech goes to Vinay Chandrasekhar K. The Institute Gold Medal for MSc Digital Society goes to Shravya C.
Thank you, sir. Heartiest congratulations to all the medal winners. I now request our chief guest, Professor Jitendra Malik, Arthur J. Chick Professor of EECS University of California at Berkeley, to kindly deliver the convocation address.
My name is Jitendra Malik. It's my pleasure to be here at this occasion. I want to start by acknowledging the honored guests at this venue, Mr. Krishna Kumar, Mr. Chris Gopalakrishnan, Chairman of the Board, Director Sadgopan, and all the faculty, and of course, all of you graduates. This is a wonderful day for you. It's a pity that in these COVID times, we have to do everything virtually, but the world has to adapt and we must carry on because we have no alternative. It is a very important occasion, and what I would like to do today is to make a few remarks which may be of some help. I'm going to start with some general remarks about what I think of as the history of computer science in India and the evolution of computer science both in academia and in industry in India. And then I would like to end with some more personal remarks in the sense of advice to you as a graduate today. So I think the history of computer science in India can only be thought of in the context of the broader history of science and technology in India. And let us begin the story immediately after independence. So our first Prime Minister, Jawaharlal Nehru, was dealing with a very, very difficult situation. I mean, if you look at the numbers, the literacy rate in India was 18%. Life expectancy was abysmal. They were just coming off the tragedy of partition. And yet Nehru felt that India, in order to succeed eventually, would need to make investments in science and technology. He supported science and technology in various forms. He supported TIFR, IISc, individuals like Bhabha, and very relevantly for us, the development of the IITs, the Indian Institutes of Technology. So the Indian Institutes of Technology got started around in the late 1950s and early 60s. And a key aspect there was to aim to leapfrog, to go get to technology at the highest end in the world. And for that, Nehru sought collaboration with various countries. Specifically, I will turn to the case of IIT Kanpur, because that was in collaboration with America. And specifically why I'm talking about IIT Kanpur is that because it played a major role in computer science in India. Because even at that early stage, very early 1960s, the leadership thought that computers were going to be important and they were not going to be just this very small esoteric technology used by very few. So you had the earliest computer science education programs. And in that process, various people were trained. I think the people who emerged from there in the 60s and 70s went on to play important roles in academia and in industry. So your director, Professor Sadgopan, is one of the alumni from that process. I myself am an alumnus from that process. Mr. Narayan Murthy is an alumnus from that process. And the result was obviously a lot of people who graduated went on to academia in India, some went on to academia in abroad, a lot in the United States. And there were people who set up companies and so on and so forth. So I think this was an important initial stage for computer science in India. I myself left India in 1980 and I went on to do my PhD at Stanford, and then subsequently my research career had been at Berkeley. And what I would like to note is the education that I got at that time was very, very good, and it prepared me very well. I did not feel in any sense inadequate when I was at Stanford competing with the best of America. in terms of success in India, I mean, the success of companies like Infosys, TCS, Wipro, and so on is to be noted. As the 90s evolved, the Y2K bug, et cetera, Indian software engineers became known around the world. This is perhaps even the stereotype of the Indian technology person in the West, is that it's a software person. And that has contributed significantly to the country in various ways, not just in foreign exchange, but in a sense of confidence. And that's where we are today. And what I would like to turn to is, where do we go next? How do we evaluate India's position today, and where should we go next? So it seems to me that if we compare on a world scale, which is where one should compare, the research infrastructure in India is still significantly behind what exists in obviously in US and Europe, but also in places like China. And to some extent, this is understandable. It takes a little bit of time to develop research infrastructure. So if I look at history in the 19th century, if I look at science broadly, the dominant powers were all in Europe. So Germany, United Kingdom, France, etc. And in fact, the US was quite far behind. In the 19th century, major innovations in the US are in the applied sciences on engineering, but not really in basic science. In fact, if you go to the 20th century, the early years, all the Nobel Prizes were still going to Europeans. It took some time, in fact, World War II, when the transition happened and the US became dominant. So if we follow the conventional phrasing now that the 21st century is Asia's century, you expect that there is this transition where the big countries such as China and India and others in Asia will assume their proportional role in the world, in terms of if 1/7 of the world is Indians, then 1/7 of the world scientific output should come from India, something like that. And the question, the benchmark which we must compare ourselves against is in fact that. How are we doing on that dimension? And I would say that there has been significant progress. You must compare, start with the baseline of where India was in the 1950s, immediately after independence, to where we are now. But it is clear that this is a journey which is only half finished. I think that with respect to China, I think India has clearly fallen behind. I think that this is not something which cannot be surmounted. It just requires continued work and progress. I should mention one particular sector which I want to draw attention to, because to me this seems like a particular gap in the Indian computer science community, and that is AI, artificial intelligence, or machine learning, or whatever the various subfields of AI like computer vision, natural language processing that you may want to consider. So this is an interesting field. This is my own field. I did my PhD in this area in 1985, and I've been working in this field. For a very long time, this was considered a very esoteric dream. People talked about it, but there was nothing real and practical. It was much more of wishful thinking than real results. But this has changed significantly. And this has changed because of the availability of computing at a very large scale and the availability of data at a very large scale. And big data, big computing, as well as techniques like deep learning have come together to cause major advances in AI in the last 5 to 10 years. And to the extent that we now have very practically fielded systems that can detect objects, that can translate from one language to another, that can read radiology images, et cetera, et cetera. And I think that this is something which is very important for computer scientists in India to engage in. And it is the case that I don't think it is the case that there are significant barriers to entry. There are some fields of science and technology where a lot of equipment is necessary, and there's a lot of prior expertise that you want to draw on. For example, if you want to build a nuclear submarine, you need many, many different kinds of technology, and a country is going to take a long time before it has the technology base for that, or for supersonic fighter planes, and so on and so forth. But AI in that sense is not a technology which has significant barriers to entry. You have packages such as TensorFlow and PyTorch. People release their models publicly. We live in the era of the internet where you can download papers. Everything is available on archive or on YouTube, and there are MOOCs that people can take, et cetera, et cetera. So there are no significant barriers to entry. It is a question of getting down and exploiting what is known and developing it further. Why should we care? Okay, why should India care about this? And I think, first of all, when you have a significant branch of science and technology, you cannot afford to neglect it. Secondly, I think there are many problems, very many practical and human problems in the Indian context, which will be solved better if AI is exploited. So think of problems in agriculture, or think of problems in health. For example, cheap tests for diagnosing tuberculosis. Problems like this, where there is always a country-specific or region-specific context, are ones where researchers in the US or Europe may not have the same motivation to study those problems. And yet, these techniques can certainly be exploited in those settings. And that's the kind of thing that I want to encourage you as graduates to consider. I'll give you an example of this perspective. This is not from AI, but this is from the research of someone called Kirk Smith. He was a professor at Berkeley. He died recently. He used to study environmental pollution. And from his visits to India, he noticed that when people are cooking in indoor sort of kitchens and on the good old chula, then there is all the smoke being produced. And he was curious about what is the magnitude of this effect. And it turns out that this is a very, very significant source of pollution. And that this cooking on these open wood stoves, and that, of course, is very harmful to the health of the person doing the cooking. Very often it will be a woman, and obviously to general atmospheric pollution. Now, think about this problem. Could this not have been studied by Indian scientists? Certainly it could have been. The technology required is not immense. What it needs is, it does need some technology and science, but more importantly, it needs the desire and openness to look at the problems right in front of you. So that's what creative people do, and that's what we need to inculcate broadly. Look at the problems right in front of your eyes, bring to bear whatever science and technology you know, and I'm sure good things will happen. So I next want to turn to advice to each of you as an individual who is graduating today and going out into the world of science, academia, or industry. So I have a few principles that I have accumulated over time, and I want to share them with you. The first piece of advice that I want to give is, be a lifelong learner. We are in a technologically very active field, and things keep changing. And what you have to do is to always think that some fraction of my time I'm going to devote to keeping on learning new things. We are fortunate that we live in a time where information is so readily accessible. I mean, you can find books, you can find papers, articles, MOOCs, YouTube videos, et cetera, with which you can keep in touch with the cutting edge technology. Everything is available publicly. And this is something that you can exploit. My second bit of advice is aim for excellence yourself, but also recognize and support excellence. You will be in organizations. There will be positions of power that you will be in. And in there, it is your duty to try to focus on merit. You need to try to encourage good people who are working hard and who are accomplishing things. What you have to try to rise above are various kinds of biases that may come to you. We all have those biases. Those biases come from people you are familiar with. I mean, it could be religion, caste, political attitudes, whatever. One has to try to rise above those and try to promote excellence in among all people, whether or not they belong to our own comfort zone and people with whom we share so much more of our cultural background. My third remark is that be confident. I think you've been trained at IIIT Bangalore. You've got a very good education. You know that people with your kind of background and your kind of education have been successful in all walks of life. You can be too. That confidence is what is essential to inspire you to tackle hard problems, because it takes as much detailed work to tackle an important problem as it does to tackle an unimportant problem. So why not tackle the important problems instead? So that's the spirit with which one should proceed. I'm sure you will do that, and I wish you the very best of luck in your onward journey. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. I request the guest of honor, Mr. N. Krishnakumar, founder and former chairman, Mindtree, managing partner, Mela Ventures, to address the gathering.
Dr. S. Sarugopan, director, International Institute of Information Technology, Bangalore. Mr. Krish Gopalakrishnan, Chairman, Board of Governors, IIITB, and co-founder, ex-CEO and Vice Chairman of Infosys. Dr. Jitendra Malik, chief guest for today's convocation address. Distinguished faculty, support staff, excited parents who are a part of this e-convocation and who are happy watching their dreams come true. Graduating students, ladies and gentlemen. It's indeed a pleasure for me to deliver the guest of honor address at the 20th convocation of International Institute of Information Technology, Bangalore. IIITB has been a trendsetter in technology education and has won laurels for the students as well as the research work done at the institute in India and abroad. I would think that all of you have been fortunate to be a part of this great institution, and graduating from this institute itself will open many doors as you enter the big unfamiliar world where you must demonstrate your value and capability to win respect and recognition. These are unusual times. Never in the history of business and mankind have you seen such a development which impacts health, economy, and the mental state of the society. But unusual times calls for unusual responses, which are driven by a sense of optimism and hope rather than fear and mistrust. So my first request to you, graduating students, would be that while the world outside looks very daunting and frightening, step out of the institute with optimism and hope. And this can help you manage the challenges better than fear and mistrust. With the sort of information overload all of us have, it's only natural that you may get into the mindset of fear as well as the mistrust of what the world ahead holds for you. But that cannot help you come out of the challenges, because the world has clearly seen that people with no resources enable address challenges much more effectively when they start acting with optimism and trust. There are many stories which have taught us that optimism and hope with perseverance leads to a lot of positive outcome. Let me share with you one of the recent ones. And I must be honest, I have a bias here because this is from our own state, Karnataka. I'd like to share with you the story of Pratap NM from Mandya, who with very little educational background, very little financial background to support him, has developed over 600 drones. And what is most impressive about his achievement is that he comes from an agricultural family whose earnings were a very meager 2,000 rupees per month. Because of the lack of resources, he could not go to a formal education and hence had to settle for a bachelor's degree in physics. But that did not stop him from dreaming about learning electronics, learning about drones, and doing a lot of self-learning. Now, the resource constraint was so hard that he had to vacate the hostel which he had. He did really prepare for his last phase of education, living on the streets. But still, he continued his dream of building his capability in electronics, building his interest in drones, which in a way led him to participate in events which started recognizing him. But partly, getting that external recognition is not adequate, because many times, many of us give up at the first sign of a bottleneck which we see, which is where the whole element of perseverance comes in. Now, as you graduate out of the institute, you must have a big audacious goal. You may not have the ability to know how you'll reach there, but that big audacious goal is important to keep you focused, to keep you persevering, even when you face many bottlenecks and come out of it successfully. Here again, we have great examples of people who have done it in a much larger scale at a global level. Many times we talk about Satya Nadella, who did his engineering from the Manipal Institute of Technology and has today rose to become the CEO of Microsoft. And the transformation which is done in Microsoft is just stunning. I think as a large company, the value it has delivered to his stakeholders is amongst the best. And he has done it, and he has not got constrained because he has come in from maybe an institute where he did engineering, which is not known globally. Today, he's a global leader at par with many of the people who have gone to more recognized institutions like the Harvard Business School. So the ability to dream big, the ability to perceive and not give up when you face bottlenecks is most important. And I think this is particularly important in the context of the situation which you're in today. I think a lot of people talk about the downsides of such a pandemic, but there is going to be a brighter world beyond this. If you look at both economic cycles as well as how societies have faced scenarios, There has been ups and there has been downs also. But just because we face a challenge and a headwind now does not mean that we are going to be in this forever. You must think with hope and optimism, like I mentioned earlier, and have your big audacious goal, which is personal to you. Be comfortable that you do not know how you are going to reach it, but perceive and not give up when you face bottlenecks. I'd like to sort of share with you a quote of David Cameron, the ex-Prime Minister of UK. He said, "I believe in life, you have to give things your best shot. Do your best. You have to focus on what needs to be done. Do the right thing and not what is most popular." And this is, I think, a very important message as graduating students. I want you to take, saying that as you go out, build your own dreams, do the right thing and not what is the most popular thing. Keep this in mind, whether you want to be a job seeker, seeking to create a high impact with your invention, with the sort of contribution you make. Or some of you may have the dream to start something on your own and you want to be a job creator. As people who come in from a technology institute of international repute, I would certainly urge some of you to think of how you can apply the tremendous knowledge which you've gained in this institute and help the society deploy technology for solving large social problems. So whether you're going to be a job seeker, a job creator, or somebody who wants to impact the society with your capability in technology, you must give it your best shot and do what is right and not what is popular. The journey ahead will involve a lot of self-discovery, and only you yourself can solve the puzzle. The grounding which you've got at IIITB will certainly help you manage this puzzle far more effectively. The twists and turns in discovering yourself will throw up surprises. At times, you will be frustrated. But when you find a solution, you would be most contented because you have addressed the problem yourself and you have found the solution. In a way, I feel as you get out of the institute, you need to formulate your thought on who do you want to be. And this is a question of self-discovery. And I would urge you to enjoy this journey of self-discovery with hope and optimism, and not fear and mistrust, because the current environment can push you to do things with fear and mistrust. I wish you all the very best in this very exciting journey. God bless, and thank you.
Thank you, sir. I request our chairman, Mr. S. Gopalakrishnan, to address the gathering.
Professor Jiten Malik, Mr. N.K. Krishna Kumar, distinguished guests, members of the Board of Governors, members of the Senate, director, faculty and staff, students, family and friends. First, congratulations to all the graduating students. Your hard work has paid off, and today, all of you are looking forward to a brighter future armed with a degree from IIIT Bangalore. I also congratulate your family and friends since they have supported you in this endeavor. You are graduating at a time when the world is going through a very difficult period, once in a lifetime occurrence. Certainly nobody predicted this pandemic, nor were we prepared for the consequences. We are all learning and adjusting to the new normal we live in. Life is full of twists and turns. Learning from nature, which has had billions of years to fine-tune its ability to survive, and taking cue from the theory of evolution by Charles Darwin, it's not the most intellectual of the species that survives. It's not the strongest that survives, but the species that survives is the one that is able to best adapt and adjust to the changing environment in which it finds itself. As you step out to your next innings in your lives, I have three suggestions and a request. First suggestion is around creating the future. You have the opportunity to actively create a better future for yourself and the world, especially here in India. India is a developing country. All sectors of our economy will undergo changes in the next 20 to 30 years. Per capita income, which is today around $2,000, will increase to $10,000 over the next 20 to 30 years, and India will become a $10 trillion economy. This new India will be built on innovation, better products and services, new business models, new leadership in all walks of life, and better quality of life for all Indians. As we participate in building this new India, please ensure that you are building a more equitable, inclusive, and sustainable India. Second suggestion is about your goals for the future. In today's world, pursuit of knowledge happens throughout our lives. In our jobs, we are continuously learning, improving, and working. You'll be taking decisions to impact others in the products that you design, on the students that you teach, on the regulations that you write, on the businesses you start, or on the family that you create. In everything that you do, please strive for excellence and act with integrity. Life is short when you look at the age of our planet and our universe. Be the best and hold yourself to a higher set of values. The third suggestion is around the definition of success. Is it about titles and the number of people reporting to you? Is it about the salary that you get? Is it about going abroad for work? Is it about how rich you are? I believe this is transitory in nature and can be taken away. I want you to define success in terms of how successful you make people around you. Measure your success in terms of successes of people around you. Even if you make one person's life better, I will consider you to be successful. Your own success is the outcome of the successes of people around you. For example, how will a teacher measure his or her success? By how well the students do in the future. Now, let me come to my request to each one of you. Your relationship to IIIT must not end today. This is a lifelong relationship. You are now an alumnus of IIIT Bangalore. Please nurture this. Drop in sometimes and meet your professors. Conduct a seminar for the students. Mentor a student startup from IIIT Bangalore. And give back time and money to the institute. The institute's brand value is enhanced by your successes, and we want to celebrate your successes. So please keep us informed as you reach new milestones in your lives. Finally, all the best in your endeavors. As the Jedi Master Obi-Wan Kenobi says in the movie Star Wars, may the Force be with you. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. I now request Professor Vishwanath to deliver the vote of thanks.
Honorable dignitaries, our chief guest, Professor Jitendra Malik, our guest of honor, Mr. N. Krishna Kumar, our chairman, Mr. S. Gopalakrishnan, our director, Professor Satagopan, and all other members of the governing body and Senate members and all other dignitaries present here online, please accept our sincere appreciation for being present here in this online avatar of 20th convocation of IIIT Bangalore and making it a memorable event. It is indeed a pleasure to have a pioneer in computer vision like Professor Jitendra Malik as our chief guest. Sir, please accept our deepest appreciation from the bottom of our hearts for accepting our invitation and finding some time to spend with our students. I am sure that the thoughts you have shared will stay with them for much longer time and help them in finding new barriers or breaking new barriers as they embark on their futuristic careers. Our guest of honor, Mr. N. Krishna Kumar, please accept our sincere thanks for being present here and sharing your thoughts with our students. As a leader and a mentor in the Indian IT scenario, you have always been an inspiration to all of us, and I hope that your work will continue to motivate many future entrepreneurs and technologists coming out of our institute. Our chairman of the governing body and the co-founder of Infosys, Mr. S. Gopalakrishnan, your continued support to this institute is always appreciated and needed. Your unabated support for all the initiatives that we take in this institute, whether it is infrastructural, whether it is R&D, or whether it is academic, has always helped us to scale much greater heights. Please accept our sincere thanks for being present here and sharing your thoughts with our students. I would also like to acknowledge the members of the governing body and the Senate members for their continuous support in all our academic endeavors. To the graduating class, our hearty congratulations as you step out of this institute and embark on a new future career. We hope that the motto of IIIT be Jnanam Uttam will be always close to your hearts and you understand it in its true essence. And as you seek the knowledge that will help you in your life skills as and beyond. We also hope that the bonds that you have discovered here in this campus will stay with you forever, and we expect you to see as a valuable alumni back in our institute. I also acknowledge all the IT companies who has the IT companies which are placed in Bangalore and rest of India and abroad as well, who has helped our students with the internships, the employments, and the research opportunities. We also acknowledge the donors of all the medals and scholarships for the outstanding students of the graduating class. We would also like to acknowledge certain people and entities and institutions without whom this event would not have been possible. The Government of India and Government of Karnataka for their unfailing support, the LCTA and CISF for all their arrangements, the administrative support staff, the student volunteers, the security personnel, our friends and guests from the media who will be covering this event. To everyone, our sincere thanks for making this event a success. Last but not the least, I would like to acknowledge the members of IIITB family for tirelessly planning, coordinating and executing this event under the hood of countless constraints we are facing in these uncertain times. Thank you everyone. Thank you for being present here and thank you for making this event a memorable and successful one. Thank you.
Thank you, Professor. I request our chairman to declare the convocation closed.
I declare the 20th convocation of the International Institute of Information Technology, Bangalore, closed.
Thank you, sir. I request the gathering to kindly rise for the national anthem. पंजाब सिंधु गुजरात हिमाचल यमुना जन्म उत्सल जल तब शुभ नामे दाने तब शुभ आशीष मांगे गावे तब जय गाथा जन गण मंगल गायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता जय हे We congratulate all the graduating students and wish them all the best. Thank you and have a nice day.